entrepreneur, a lot of people try to put a color thing in it.
Yes.
You know, they be going like, well, they don't want me to make it because I'm black.
Right.
In the music business, it's prejudice, but it's not black and white. It's young and old. Because, you know, the older people used to be the ones where say, oh, you got some groups, you want to be an entrepreneur? Mm-hmm. Give me all you got. Give me your money, and I'll put your stuff out. Mm-hmm. I mean, I knew some of the people who they call themselves legends in the music business who have been the biggest disappointments in the world. And I used to never say nothing negative about them. No interviews, no nothing, because I felt it didn't matter. I mean, I knew Dick Griffey. Now, I knew Dick from since I was a youngster. Mm-hmm. And when I used to come to Dick with groups, he said, okay, why don't you loan me some money first, number one. Let me sell you a studio that I don't own, but Sony owns, but I say I own it, and it's yours. And, you know, we bought it, which it wasn't his to sell. Then he'll turn around and wait till you get all the stuff you got done for his discovering the Snoop Dogg and make sure he had money for his being there with the studio with him, make sure shit go all right. Then he'll tell you, well, I don't believe in rap music. I don't want to deal with no rapper. I don't want to deal with a DJ Quick. But all of a sudden, when it hits, he want to turn around and say, give it to me. It's mine. I want it. So it leaves a bitter taste in your mouth when it comes to for us older black men in the business, because I wouldn't say men, males, because these clowns who call themselves men ain't no, you know, they ain't no man. They males. They walking around trying to take from the, you know, the youngsters and turn into their wealth, because they went Hollywood and got out of touch. So, you know, you got to deal with a lot. When you're a young entrepreneur, you finna deal with the older black men in the business that try to steal what you got. You finna deal with the women who's gold diggers who try to take what you got. Then you finna deal with the guys who's jealous of you, who try to lie on you and put you in jail. Then you got to deal with the police who might be jealous of you, who try to put you in jail. So you got a lot on your plate to deal with. But if you stay true to yourself and be a man about it, if you're a man and you're a man of God, you can deal with it. Right now, I ain't saying I want to go to jail. But if I went to jail, you ain't gonna see me up there crying. You ain't finna see me hanging myself. You gonna see me in jail calling home saying, everybody all right? Y'all got some money? Everything good? That type of stuff. So that's the type of thing that we up against and we got to deal with.
Mm-hmm.
So it's sort of crazy.
Yeah, you should be out encouraging young people who, because I get tired of that talk about we can't do it because somebody's holding us back. And then we see examples like you, and we're like, wait a minute, somebody's got to be right. Either you lying or they're lying.
Right.
So it's very interesting.
But one of the things I said not to cut you off is,
yeah,
a lot of the entrepreneurs who make it, it's not really the youngster's fault. It's our fault. Mm-hmm. It's my duty to go back and get them some game and say, look, I made it like this, this, this.